गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट, वेलकम इन एनबीएसएम स्टडी सेंटर, कोड नंबर 62333, दैट इज अशोक विद्यालय इन दी प्योर फॉर्म। ओके, टुडे वी लर्निंग द प्रोग्रामिंग यूजिंग C++, दैट इज फर्स्ट ईयर ऑफ बीसीए। वन सब्जेक्ट इज देयर, दैट इज CMP 503 एंड इट्स CMP 703। So guys, today we start the programming using C++. Before learning C++, we have to know or we have to meet some concepts in C language. So let us read the introduction of C or overview of C. Okay, so C is a general purpose language which is the very closely associated with Unix, for which it was developed in Bell Laboratories. Okay, so most of the programs of Unix are written in run with the help of C language. Then many of the important ideas of C streams are the from BCPL by Martin Richards. In 1972, Dennis Ritchie at Bell Laboratory wrote the C language, which caused a revolution in computing world. From beginning, C was intended to be useful for the busy programmers to get things done easily, because C is the powerful, dominant, and simple language. So why name C was given in this language? Why name of C? Then many of ideas of C language were derived and taken from B language. म्हणजे काय, जेव्हा सी लँग्वेज तुमची आली त्याच्या आधी अजून एक लँग्वेज होती, कोणती? ती म्हणजे बी लँग्वेज। त्याच्यानंतर आपण काय केलं की सी लँग्वेज आलेली आहे। देन बीसीपीएल अँड सीपीएल आर प्रिव्हियस वर्जन ऑफ बी लँग्वेज, एज मेनी फीचर came from B, it was named as C language. Okay, so it is important why name of C. Then about C, pre-programming language, that is structured and disciplined approach to programming design. Then C is a structured programming language. C supports function that enables easy maintainability of code by breaking large files into smaller modules. C supports what? C supports function that enables easy maintainability of code by breaking large files into small modules. Then comments in C provides easy readability. Then C is a powerful language. C programs built from variables, type declaration, functions, statements, expression, like that things. C programs build. Then C program language. C programming language मध्ये आपण काय बघणार आहे? काय बघणार आहे? Functions बघणार आहे, operators बघणार आहे, expressions बघणार आहे, statements कसे लिहायचे ते बघणार आहे, त्याचा flow control कसा आहे ते शिकणार आहोत आपण. त्याच्यानंतर variable declaration कसं करायचं किंवा variable म्हणजे काय, how to use variable, then how to give the output, then what is the C compiler. And all those things we have to learn in C language programming. Then structure of C program. Before going and reading the structure of C program, we need to have a basic knowledge of the following statements. That is C character set. Then C keywords. म्हणजे C मध्ये कॅरेक्टर सेट काय आहे, C चे कीवर्ड्स कोणते आहेत. The general structure of C program, how to end a statement, free format language, then header file, library function, variables, etc. etc. That is the structure of C program. So C character set. C does not use every character set and key found on modern computers. The only characters that C language uses for its programming are as follows. A to Z, all alphabets we are using in C programs, that is capital letters. Also A to Z, small letters are also using in C language. Then 0 to 9 integer. Then special statements, special keyword. That is hash, percent, ampersand, not equal to, curly bracket, square bracket, round bracket, dollar sign, ampersand sign, then space, comma, colon, semicolon, etc. Single quote, double quote. Then operators are used, that is plus, minus, division, star, equal to. That is the character set of in C language. Then the keywords. What is the keywords? Keywords are the words that have special meaning of the C compiler. Their meaning cannot be changed at any instant. Serve as basic building blocks for program statements. All keywords are written in only lowercase. Then basic structure of C programs. That's a basic structure. C programs a basic structure. कसं लिहायचं C programming? तर बघा पहिल्या लाईनला काय लिहितो आपण, हॅश इन्क्लूड stdio डॉट h. देन हॅश इन्क्लूड conio डॉट h. ह्याला काय म्हणणार आहे आपण ह्या दोन लाईनला? दिस इज द हेडर फाइल्स. जे stdio डॉट एच आणि conio डॉट एच ह्या काय हेडर फाईल आहेत, की त्याच्यामध्ये काहीतरी इम्पॉर्टंट स्टेटमेंट जे आहेत ते आपण फॉलो करणार. ओके, देन void main, दॅट इज एंट्री पॉइंट ऑफ प्रोग्राम. म्हणजे कुठलाही तुम्ही सीचा प्रोग्राम लिहित असताना हे स्टेटमेंट तर येणारच आहेत हेडर फाईलचे. त्याच्यानंतर व्हॉइड मेन ह्याचा हा जो मेन एंट्री पॉइंट असतो प्रोग्रामिंगचा तोही कंपल्सरी लिहावाच लागतो. त्याच्यानंतर कर्ली ब्रॅकेट ओपन करायचं. त्याच्यानंतर त्याच्यामध्ये जो काही आपण कोड लिहिणार तो त्या फंक्शन मध्ये किंवा त्या एंट्री पॉइंट मध्ये लिहायचं. दिस मीन्स व्हॉट इंडिकेट स्टार्टिंग ऑफ प्रोग्राम देन अदर स्टेटमेंट. म्हणजे आपल्याला जो ऍक्च्युली प्रोग्रामिंगचा कोड लिहायचा आहे सी मधून तो आपण काय कुठं लिहिणार आहे अदर स्टेटमेंट मध्ये लिहिणार आहे. त्याच्यानंतर कर्ली ब्रॅकेट कम्प्लीट करायचं. त्याच्यानंतर काय करायचं की तो प्रोग्राम जो लिहिलेला असतो आपण तो कशामध्ये लिहिणार आहे आपण टर्बो सी मध्ये लिहिणार आहे. टर्बो सी सॉफ्टवेअर डाउनलोड करायचं आणि ते यूज करायचं प्रोग्रामिंगसाठी. तर त्याच्यामध्ये तो सेव्ह करायचा आणि त्याच्यानंतर तो रन करून बघायचा. आधी कंपाईल करायचा किती तुमचे एरर्स येतात किंवा कसा तुम्ही प्रोग्राम लिहिलेला आहे बरोबर आहे किती एरर्स आहेत हे तुम्हाला टेस्टिंग करून सांगतं ते सॉफ्टवेअर. त्याच्यानंतर काय करायचं की जे काही एरर असतील ते सॉल्व्ह करायचे परत कंपाईल करून तो प्रोग्राम रन करायचा सीचा. ओके देन हेडर फाईल्स. व्हॉट इज मीन बाय हेडर फाईल्स? द फाईल्स दॅट आर स्पेसिफाईड इन द इन्क्लूड सेक्शन इज कॉल्ड एज व्हॉट हेडर फाईल. व्हॉट इज मीन बाय हेडर फाईल? द फाईल that are specified in the include section is called as header file. Okay, these are pre-compiled files that has some functions defined in them. We can call those functions in all program by supplying parameters, and header file is given an extension .h. And C source file is given an extension is .c. Okay? आपण जेव्हा प्रोग्राम सेव्ह करतो तेव्हा कसा करायचा त्याचं एक्सटेन्शन काय असलं पाहिजे .c. Then main function. This is the entry point of program. When a file is executed, the start point is the main function. From main function, the flow goes as per the programmer's choice. There may or may not be other functions written by the user in a program. The main functions is compulsory for any C programs. Then, running a C program. How to run a C program? This is the type of program. Then, save it. Then compile the program. This will generate an exe file that is executable file. And run the program. Actually the exe created out of the compilation will run and not the .c file. In different compilers, we have different options for compiling and running. Then C language tokens. What is the tokens in C language? The smallest individual unit in C program are known as what? Token. What? The smallest individual units in a C program are known as a token. In a C source program, the basic element recognized by the compiler is the token. A token is source program text that the compiler does not break down into component elements. C has six different type of tokens. First is keywords. For example, what? Float, integer, while, etc. Then second is what? Identifiers. Identifiers, for example, is main, amount, etc. Then third one is the constants. Constants means constant. For example, 25.6, 101, 102, 101, 1000. That is the constant. Then fourth one is the strings. What is strings? Group of character is known as what? String. For example, in double quote, ear. In double quote, SMIT. That is the string. Then fifth number is special symbol. That is curly bracket, square bracket, etc. Then operators. What is the operators? Plus, minus, division, star, multiply, not equal to, equal to. These are the operators. The C programs are written using these tokens and the general syntax. Then what is the keyword C? Unsee. So see the keywords in C language. Atto, double, register, switch, break, else, return, type date, case, enum, short, union, character, eat, return, sign, unsigned, constant, float, size of, void, continue, for, static, volatile, default, go to, struct, while, do, if, integer, long, like this. These are the keywords in C language. The identifiers. They are program chosen name to represent parts of the program, variables, functions, etc. It cannot use C keywords as identifiers. Then must begin with alpha character or followed by alpha, numeric or underscore. Then upper and lower case characters are important, that is case sensitive. Must consist of only letters, digits, underscore. Then only first 31 characters are significant. Then must not contain the space. That is, in brackets, space is there. Then constants. What is the constant? Constants in C are the fixed values that do not change during the execution of a program. So there are two types of constants. First is numeric constant and second is character constant. So in numeric there are two types of constants. In numeric there are integer constant and real constant, and character constant. Then in character constant there are single character constant and second is the string constant. Okay, so constant example, see the constant example. First is what? Integer constant. Integer means what? Simple question. What is mean by integer? Yes. These are the numbers. Okay. So refers to sequence of digits such as decimal integer, octal integer, and hexadecimal integer. Some of the examples are 112, 0551, 56, 579U. That is what? Hexadecimal number. Then 0x2, that is hexadecimal number, etc. then what is the real constant? The floating point constant. The floating point constant, such as 0.0083 or minus 0.78 or plus 6789, etc. That is the real constant. Then single character constant. A single character constant contain a single character enclosed within pair of single quotes, that is in bracket single quote. For example, how to write the in single quote, that is A. See here A, see here I, etc. Then string constant. A string constant is a sequence of four characters enclosed in double quotes. Okay. So for example, in double quote, here is 0 to 1. Here is in double quote, stack overflow, etc. Then declaration. Constant and variable must be declared before they can be used. A constant declaration specifies the type, the name and the value of the constant. Any attempt to alter the value of variable defined as constant results in an error message by the compiler. As constant results in an error message by the compiler. A variable declaration specifies the type, the name, and possibly the initial value of the variable. When you declare a constant or a variable, the compiler reserves a memory location in which to store the value of the constant or variable. And next is associates the name of the constant or variable with the memory location. What are the variables in C? So a variable is a data name that is used to store any data value. Then variables are used to store value that can be changed during the program execution. Then variable is a in C have the some meaning as variable in algebra. That is, they represent some unknown or variable value. So here x is equal to a plus b, then z plus 2 equal to 3y minus 5. Remember that variables in algebra are represented by a single alphabetic character. So naming variables. Variables in C may be given representations containing multiple characters, but there are rules for this representation. Then variable names in C. How to give variable names in C? See, the first point may only consist of letters, digits, and underscores. Then may be the as long as you like the, but only the first 31 characters are significant. May not begin with a number. May not be reserved word, that is keyword. The keywords are variables and name tumhi dilo tar kay honar, obviously tumhala error yenar program madhe. Then should start with a letters and underscore. Next is can contain letters and numbers or underscore. No other special characters are allowed, including the space. जे variable name तुम कसं देणार आहे, एकतर ते characters असतील, letters असतील, digits असतील किंवा underscore वापरून तुम्ही variableचं नाव देऊ शकता. Okay, then case sensitive. C is a case sensitive language. It matters whether an identifier such as a variable name is uppercase or lowercase. So see the example, how to write first area, how to write second area, third and fourth are all seen as different variables by the compiler. Then declaring variables. Before using a variable, you must give the compiler some information about the variable. That is, you must declare it. The declaration statement includes the data type of the variable. For example, of variable declaration, integer length or float area, like that. म्हणजे आपण इंटीजर लेंथ कशात लिहिणार आहे, इंटीजर मध्ये, आणि एरिया कशा मध्ये आपण डेटा टाइप काय दिला त्याचा फ्लोट, म्हणजे हा फ्लोट मध्ये त्याचा एरिया असणार आहे आणि इंटीजर असणार आहे त्याची लेंथ. देन व्हेरिएबल आर ऑटोमॅटिकली इनिशियलाइज, फॉर एक्झाम्पल आफ्टर डिक्लेरेशन, दॅट इज इन सम सेमीकोलन. द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ द व्हेरिएबल सम कॅन बी एनीथिंग, दॅट इज गार्बेज व्हॅल्यू. Thus, it is good practice to initialize variables when they are declared. Once a value has been placed in a variable, it stays there until the program alerts it. Then, data types in C language or ANSI language. There are three classes of data types. First is primitive data types, second is derived data types, and third is the user-defined data type. So what is the primitive data types? In that, integer, float, double character, like that, data types are included. Then what is the derived data type? Derived means what? Derived kelele. Okay, so arrays come under this category. Then pointers come under this category. So arrays can contain collection of integer or float or character or double, that is data type of array. Okay, so then user defined data type. User defined means what? User karun define kelela data. So structure and enum fall under this category. Then data types different attributes. See the data type, its size, its representation, its minimum range and its maximum range. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so first is the data types character, that is signed character. So its size is what? 8 bits. Its representation is ASCII representation. Its minimum range is -128 to 127 is the maximum range. Okay. Then next is what? Unsigned character. Here is what? Signed character. And next is unsigned character. That is Boolean 8 bits. That is ASCII representation. Then minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 255. Next is short, that is signed short. So its size is what? 16 bits. Then its representation is 2's complement. Then minimum range is what? -32,767. Then unsigned short. So It also 16 bits. Its representation is binary representation. Then its minimum range is 0 and maximum is 65,535. Next is integer. Integer or signed integer. हे किती साइजचे आहेत 16 bits. Also 2's complement. Then minus 32768 to 32767. Then long signed long. There are 32 bit size. Then 2's complement. And its minimum range is here minus 2147483648. To positive this value. Then unsigned long, that is also 32 bits. That is binary representation. Its minimum range is 0 and maximum range is 42949672095. Then float. Float is what? 32 bits. IEEE 32 bit, it is the representation of float. Then its minimum value is 1.175495E 2 minus 38 and maximum range is 3.4028235E plus 38. Then double. Double is the same as the float, and long double is also same the double. Okay, so these are the data types and different attributes. So see the example, simple example in C program. How to write hash include stdio.h, then void main, curly bracket open, then print hello world slash n bracket complete semicolon. Semicolon is the compulsory in C language and C++ language. Then get ch bracket complete and see the output. Output is what? Hello comma world. Then here hello world is the output. So these are the overview of C language. It is using in C++ language. So guys, today we will stop here, and next lecture we will start the programming using C++. We cover in that what is class, what is object, what is inheritance, what is polymorphism, like that point. Okay. So thank you guys.